good way to start the season. Anytime you can get a win, it's hard to win. And certainly, we did some good things. We did a lot of bad things as well. Made too many mistakes as the competition ratchets up. A lot of the things we did will deter us from getting to where we want to go. But they say you make the most improvement from game one to game two, and I hope so. It's you know, we made balls on the ground entirely too many times. We made a couple of the biggest bonehead plays in special teams that I've seen in a long, long time. We weren't as good on third down defensively as we needed to be. So there was a lot of things to work on. So, but there were some positives. I thought that especially Stephen Hume played like we thought he could. Hopefully that will be a confidence booster for him. So he had a big game. And, you know, it was just a crazy game. It was kind of crazy. The field goal right before half was just, you know, I'll have to look at it and tell you. I don't know if it was a low kick. I think it was probably a combination. But that shouldn't be such a adventure. Every time you line up to kick it, it shouldn't be an adventure. So you've got to do some things to shore a lot of that stuff.
Seemed like you threw the ball pretty well, particularly with Tevin. He was effective.
Well, we had a lot of yardage after the catch. I mean, they were really committed to trying to stop the run inside. Those guys out there were on the corners one-on-one, and they were a little bit overmatched with a couple of our guys at receiver. So, but, yeah, you know, I thought we did okay. I don't know what Tevin's final stats were. I know we probably threw a lot of yards because there was a lot of big plays.
How about the play of David Sims?
I thought David did some okay things. You know, we'll watch the tape and see. We were having a hard time getting up on the linebacker on some of our inside run plays. I know Preston Lyons had a great one. He broke about two or three tackles down by the bench when he scored. And, you know, Charles bounced back from throwing the ball and ran there. Had a nice catch on third down and ran the ball. Richard had a nice run there. So, it was a positive for those guys. Really, too, you watch the tape. It's a good play, too. I thought David played. I don't know what he ended up with rushing.
Can you talk about Orwin a little bit? He really set the pace early for guys.
He had some big plays. You know, for the most part, he's been good when he's had the ball in his hands. Had a couple of catches. He had the one drop, I remember. But Orwin's got a lot of big play ability. And when he gets the ball, I don't remember. Yeah, we're gonna have to throw the ball a little bit more because it's just we're so young on the offensive line. And you know, we've worked hard at it. The kids worked hard this summer, and we've gotten a little better at it. So protection's a little better. We're gonna have to throw a little bit more.
Freshmen made some tackles on the special teams.
I think they did. We've got to evaluate that. I mean, we've got some that did a really good job. Some bowed up. We're skirted, so we'll have to adjust and get the guys that are going down and making the tackles on some
guys. Seemed like Brandon Watts was able to make some plays and some things happened in the pass rush.
Yeah, I thought Brandon did some things. I was a little disappointed, truthfully, in our pass rush. They were getting the ball out very quickly at times, but, you know, we've got to win some one-on-ones pass rush-wise for the line. You can't depend on blitzing all the time. Running linebackers. We need some of those guys to win some of those battles.
The linebackers did seem like they were making plays, at least in the first half when the game was not out of hand.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, Julian Burnett's a really good player. And again, I have to watch the tape and see, but I know he made several plays. We had a hard time on the linebacker. Tight end single out. He caught three or four balls. That's the linebacker's responsibility. And coverage is really most of the time. So, and we had a bunch of dropped interceptions. We had, you know, just things you can't do as you ratchet up the competition.
Your first impression, what did you learn about your team that you didn't know 24 hours ago?
Well, I think anytime you got a young team, they're going to make a lot of mistakes. We made more than I thought we would. You know, like I said, some of the stuff is bonehead stuff. Some of the stuff is a little out there. I mean, you get an unsportsmanlike penalty. I guess he high-fived one of the guys in the front row or something. Yeah, it's a good to have in this game to learn. But, you know, we might be carrying out a little too far. I thought the celebration penalty was for guys who were trying to show somebody up and calm and those kind of things. But, you know, we blocked behind the ball, got a block in the back on the punt return after Zach Lasky made a great run. You know, just things you can learn from.
What was your evaluation of St. John's performance?
He did okay. Dropped some snaps. And you know, after watching the tape, I think he probably could pitch the ball a few times. He's a good runner. There's no doubt about his running ability. And he made some plays.
Was Tevin calm on the field in the huddle? Because he seemed like he was very accurate in his passes. He wasn't rushing or a little field.
Well, I think we did a little better job protecting him. And, other than one screen pass, we maybe short arms a little bit. I thought he threw the ball pretty good. And those kids made some nice catches for him. You know, the very first one that Stephen had was a little bit low, and he went down and got it. Then the last long one that he caught was a nice catch. Those guys made some nice catches for him. He was pretty accurate. Again, the last time where he goes passing. Can you see this name?
Tevin had 271 passing, 8 of 13, 3 TDs.
How did Jay Finch look to you?
You'll have to watch the tape. It's hard to evaluate those guys inside until you watch the tape.
About the secondary, the corner starts.
Well, they had their moments. You know, I'm sure they're going to get better, but. They hit some legs. They come up and hit some shots, that's for sure. So that's a positive. They're going to get better, too, the more they play, the more comfortable they get.
With the special teams, how much do you think it's first game and jitters, and how much it is just something's amiss? I know you've spent a lot of time working on it.
I don't know. I mean, I was probably as disappointed with that area as I am with anything, because we have spent a lot of time on it. And just bonehead. I mean, we've got to do a better job coaching the special teams. We just got to. Because we do some dumb stuff out there at times.
How
do what?
The overall hitting on the defensive side of the ball, what's that about your team?
I don't know. I mean, there were some pretty good hits out there at times tonight. I mean, Rod Sweeting had a couple of pretty good shots. Jameer Thomas had a hard shot. You just got to learn not to leave when you hit. There were some different guys, you know, that made some hits. I don't doubt our guys' coverage. I mean, hitting's not going to be, I don't think that's an issue. I think we got guys that hit.
Two more questions.
Is there something that you didn't sign up with the secondary knowledge of learning? That's something they can't do to make a difference?
No, I think that they were just, you know, in this game, they're a little bigger, a little faster, a little stronger than the guys that are playing.
Logan seemed like he was pretty active in the
building. Yeah, I think Logan has some tackles on the run game. He did a nice job probably. Again, you've got to, you know, you watch the tape and see, but I think he was pretty solid in there.
What are some things you know already you want to get back to this week, this coming week?
Fundamentals, getting the snap, getting the ball off the ground. Penalties. There's going to be a ton of missed assignments. Yeah, I know 5 or 6 plays we turned guys loose. The last play of the game on 4th down, we turned the guy loose. And we knew, told the guy where he was going and who to block, and which foot to stick with, and still turned him loose. Just things like that.
Okay. Thanks, Paul.